I thought it would be fun to share with you today a few of my own ideas on how to maintain a steady stream of ideas for your painting or project. Now, when I was coming up with this list, I was thinking of a lot of visual artists. As I got through the list, I actually realized that this could be applied to a lot of different creative fields. And I'm hoping that it might be applicable in your area of expertise. But before we get started, I wanted to announce the winner of my giveaway, Julie Stowen. I have an email headed your way, and thank you for everybody else that entered. This will not be the last one, I promise. So here is my list of how I go about keeping my idea bank full and overflowing. My first tip is keep a list. I keep lists for all kinds of things, and one of those things is ideas for paintings and projects. You can keep lists in a document online, or you can keep it on paper. It really doesn't matter where you keep it, as long as you know where to find it later. If you're at all an online list type person, I really enjoy and recommend using Todoist. This allows you to create a list of ideas and put them under larger projects that you might want to create in future. My next recommendation might feel a little counterintuitive, but for me, this has worked so very well over the last few years. I recommend making more work, and this could mean for you finishing up projects that you're already in the middle of, finishing up client work that might be getting in the way of your time to think about the projects that you want to be working on, or playing around with some ideas that you've maybe not felt so confident about starting, or you're not really 100% sure you want to pursue them to a finish. But getting started on those projects and making more work actually allows you to think about what you really enjoy and what you really want to be making. I highly recommend thumbnailing and sketching for creating new ideas for future projects. Thoughts put down on paper visually as little thumbnails or sketches, keeping a steady stream and dialogue between you and the paper and those ideas. I found often that allowing myself to sketch in a way that kind of creates an ambiguous scene or imagery on the paper really allows me to come up with maybe more ideas than I would have normally thought of. Something that I see a lot of artists do is repeat themes. I see a huge benefit there for repeating the same theme over and over again throughout several paintings. In this way, you can create a series of work or explore an idea to its fullest potential throughout several paintings. I feel like often I'm kind of not really finished with an idea once I've completed one painting. Often I'll have two, three, or more ideas that revolve around that same theme that I still want to explore. And if you give yourself the chance to explore those more fully into finished paintings, you're hopefully going to enjoy the process and make more work. Another benefit to repeating themes is you're going to help solidify your brand. Now, you want to be careful as a brand that you're not repeating themes that you don't want to be known for. But if this is something that you are already doing that you want to be known for and that is representational of you, I highly encourage you to explore that same idea a couple different ways and see how it takes. On that same note, I recommend trying combining old ideas and remixing them with new themes. This can be a really fun way to kind of spice up your portfolio, revisit old ideas from the past that you may or may not have felt satisfied with at the time. There are always events online that you can join that are creating work around a hashtag or a theme. I highly recommend looking at these and joining them if you're interested in challenging yourself to create new work. One of my favorite recommendations is to change your environment. I get so many ideas when I'm out traveling and spending time hiking or walking in nature, and those are the places I look to first for more ideas. On that note, I want to remind you to stay curious. When you're out in these locations, whether it be a beautiful landscape or a grungy city alleyway, you can be looking for things that will give you ideas for more paintings. Doesn't matter where you're at. If you keep your mind open to new ideas and asking questions about why things are the way they are, or putting yourself in a more playful mindset, I have found that so many more ideas are created in that process. This is the core of how I create my work. I look for things around me and I use my experiences and my environment to create work that I really enjoy. I have so many ideas that are listed out and backlogged that I would love to explore when I have the time. And I want you to be able to explore your own ideas. No artist should ever run out of ideas of things to create. And I cannot recommend more creating more work this year than you ever have before. Thank you so very much for watching. I would love to know, how do you get your ideas for your projects? Let us know in the comments below. I'm looking forward to reading those. If you haven't already, check out my Kickstarter. It is live right now until February 11th. Thank you again, and I will see you in my next video.